So, good afternoon. We are going to wait for some of our classmates to join us this afternoon for our current events class. So, there are two things we're going to do today. We're going to listen and learn an English song. This is quite a really bit romantic song. And then after that, we are going to do for we're going to transition to our current events. Hello, Pen. How are you? Are you enjoying the weather?
Hi, Miss May.
Hello. How are you and the weather? Do you like the weather?
No.
Miss Andrea hates the weather.
I'm sure. I like the summer.
Okay, maybe the two of you can go together and at the beach.
Yeah,
okay.
yes.
For the summer.
Or Bahama.
Yeah. Okay, so we're going to have a look at this lyrics. This is a song called Could I Have This Kiss Forever? Okay, as you can see, it's quite a romantic song.
Oh my God.
So this is from Enrique Iglesias and Whitney Houston. Do you know Enrique Iglesias and Whitney Houston? Anyone?
Yes.
Miss Andrea knows them, yeah?
Yes, I know. Erika Iglesias and origin Spanish, and I now live in America, I think Miami,
Yeah.
and his wife and tennis winner, but I don't know this name. Whitney Houston, a little bit older than both American actor, American
Yeah.
singer.
Yeah, very famous, isn't it? And Whitney Houston also has a very powerful voice. Yeah, very, very powerful voice. So we're going to have a look at their song, okay? It's as I said, very quite romantic and quite an old song too. Okay, so maybe the younger generation like Hailey and Regina have not heard this song before. Actually, I have not really heard this song before. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to read through the lyrics and then I'm going to play the song. And then we'll see if we can sing together this song. Okay, so maybe I'll ask Miss Andrea to read the first line. Hi, I just want to say hi to Regina and hi to Leda. How are you, ladies?
Hi, Miss May.
Miss May.
Good, thank
Hello.
you. How are you?
Good, good. Good to have you guys. Okay, so we're going to read the
Thank you.
song first, and then after that, we will try to sing this song, whatever this song is. Okay. Miss Andrea, please read to us the first line, the first stanza.
Over and over, I look in your eyes. You were all I
Desire. Yeah.
desire. You can captured me. I want to hold you. I want to be close to you. I never want to let go. I wish that this night would never end. I need to know.
Thank you. John Penn, could you do the second stanza for us, please?
Course, I hope you for right time. Course, I look into your eyes. Course, I have this night to share this night together. Course, I hope you pause beside me. Course, I hope you for all time. Course, I could you have this kiss forever. Course, I could I have this kiss forever,
Yes,
forever.
yeah. So that's what the songs are. Normally, songs are just repeating itself.
Okay.
Okay, Haley, next stanza.
Over and over, I've dreamed of this night. Now you are here by my side. You are next to me. I want to hold you and touch you, taste you, and make you want no one but me. I wish that this kiss could never end. Oh, baby, please.
Okay, next letter, the next stanza. Letter. Letter, are you here or is your microphone on the mute? Okay.
Sorry, teacher, 5 minutes because I can read because I'm going to take George, my daughter. It's
okay. 5 minutes. No problem. No problem. Take your time. Take care. Okay. Regina?
I was writing, but I don't know. Okay. Thank you.
No problem. Regina, can you read this next stanza, please?
Could I hold you for a lifetime? Could I look into your eyes? Could I have this night to share this night together? Could I hold you close behind beside me? Could I hold you for all time? Could I have this kiss forever? Could I have this kiss forever, forever?
All right, let's go back to Miss Andrea. Miss Andrea?
Sorry, I'm muted. I don't want any night to go by without you by my side. I just want all my days. Spend being next to you, lived for just loving you and baby, or by the way.
Okay, and the last stanza pen.
Could I hold you for a right time? Could I look into your eyes? Could I have this night to share this night together? Could I hold you close beside me? Could I hold you for on time? Could I have this kiss forever? Could I have this kiss forever, forever?
Okay, so let's have a look at how this sounds, this song. Okay. So I'm going to transition. I'm going to stop share and I'm going to go ahead and put this into YouTube. And I need to share with you my screen for a little bit. And of course my sound. Okay, and let's see how this romantic song goes.
Could I hold you close beside me? Could I hold you for all time? just walked on my days and spent being next to you, lived for just loving you.
Okay, everybody, what do you feel about the song? Miss Andrea, what do you feel about this song?
I never listened to this song earlier. I don't know, firstly, a little bit old type. I better like the rock music than this type, this romantic music.
You like rock music. Okay.
Yeah, better like.
A little bit more. This is a little bit more, you know, very sad and very romantic. What about Pen? What do you feel about this music?
Oh, it's really romantic. Make me little bit high.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, because it's a song. It's very nice. It's romantic, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, for me.
That's good. What about, Haley, what do you feel about this music?
It's a romantic music.
Mm-hmm.
I like it's not my type.
That's your type of music.
I'm sleeping.
Relaxing. So what type of music do you like, Haley?
Something pom 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 pom.
Oh, just like Miss Andrea, like a little bit more, you know, upbeat. Upbeat.
Yeah.
Okay, beautiful. What about Regina? Regina, are you there?
Yes. I think this sounds like romantic.
Yeah, it's romantic. Yeah.
I think it's like so want to tell someone to what he or she needs.
Mm. They're very much in love, aren't they?
Yeah.
They don't want to be separated. They don't want to be together forever. Hi, Jaya.
Hi, teacher. How are you?
Were you able to listen to the song?
No, teacher.
Oh, unfortunately, you weren't able to listen to the song. Okay. So we were like listening to this song, Could I Have This Kiss Forever? So what I'm going to do is, for those of you who might want to listen to it again, then I'm going to copy this in the chat box so that for those of you who like romantic song, or if you feel like this is good for the weather, then maybe you can just listen to this song. Okay, so here at the activity section of our module, we can see that we are going to look at a simple present verb tense question plus a time phrase. So for example, you will have simple present tense from the song, and then we have a frequency phrase. So the subject here is could I, we have verb hold, the object is you, and the frequency phrase is life, for a lifetime. So let's see if we can find some of these kind of expressions in the song. I'm going to give you a couple of minutes to have a look at the song and see if we can find these kind of sorry, question presented, okay? So could I, then a verb, then an object, and then a frequency phrase. And if you find something, please let me know and I'll type it down. And I'll type it here.
Then I can find this under
this song. Okay, so
I found the song on YouTube, but Echidna. Okay, thank you. I see the number.
Yeah, so you go to Echidna. Sorry, yes. I just
okay. M252.
So in grammar, it's in grammar.
Grammar.
Yeah, in the middle.
Grammar in the middle. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay, so just help me out, guys. Find me these kind of expressions. Could I? Some of them doesn't have a timeline marker, but some of them have a frequency phrase marker. So could I hold you for all time? So you have subject, you have the question, subject, the verb, object, and then frequency phrase. This is for a lifetime. It's not a lot, but we can find a couple, I think. Have you found any?
I have a question.
Yes, Miss Andrea.
Could I have this night to share this night together? I, the subject, have the same verb. Have is okay.
Yeah.
Have this night to share. I think this is object.
Yeah.
And this night, this time phrases.
Yeah, this night. Yeah, that's a time phrase. Yeah.
It's okay.
Yeah. So can you repeat that for me? Could.
I have this night.
So this night is your object to share.
This night to share.
Yeah.
This night to share.
This night. So this night is the time object, yeah. Time frame. Yeah. Good. I have this night to share this night. Okay.
I understand. I think this subject only I, but in the first colon subject could I? I think only I. Subject.
Yeah, could is the question. So,
yes, so, but yeah, the question. That I think in my line could I think yeah. only I.
Yeah. Okay. Anyone else? Has anyone find something? Check. Share. Okay.
Could I have these keys forever? Forever yeah. then find the frequency phrases. And so, I could I this subject.
So we just have to choose one could I, because the song is just
yes, I see the repeat.
Because of because just of the style.
Object could this key.
Could I have?
Have.
This kiss is the object, and then forever is the time. Yeah. So could I have this kiss forever? Did we find anything else? Some don't have time frame, but they could have subject, verb, and object as well. What about?
I just want all my days. I subject just. I think they just. Just I don't know which. Want verb and want all my days. This is subject or time. This is. I just want all my days. All my days. This is subject phrases.
Where is it? I just want
all my days.
Is it above or below?
Under.
What number of stanza, please?
Five. Sorry, past five is me.
I just want all my days.
Yes.
Yeah, so I. Mm-hmm. Want
I subject.
Want is yeah. Want is your verb.
I want my days. I ask this all my days. Time is there or subject? Object. Sorry.
Object and a time marker at the same time. It's also an object. Yeah.
Object.
But it's also a time marker because it's talking about a time.
Meaning time, but. Please this object.
Yes, uh-huh. Correct.
And what is the just?
Just is it's more of like just an insertion of your. It's like you're giving an emphasis on your sentence. So it's adverb that is giving that's modifying whatever. Want. Yeah, it's an adverb. Yeah. Adverb modifying want. I just want. Yeah. Is there anything else we found?
No.
What about I could hold you for all time? So it's basically.
Mm-hmm.
Just different kind of time phrase. The other one is a lifetime. So this one, could I hold you for a lifetime? And the other one is, could I hold you for all time? Yeah, could I hold you for all time? Okay, is there anything else?
Maybe could I look into your eyes? No.
Could I look into your eyes? Yes, there is no time frame, but this is a subject, verb, and an object. Yeah. The same as could I hold you close beside me? So.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, so I subject, verb, and then object, but there's no time frequency phrase there. All right, so we all know how to identify subject, verb, and object now. And of course, frequency phrase. Do we have questions so far with this song?
Do you want to sing this song?
Sorry?
We sing this song.
We will try to sing this song. I don't know how to sing this song as well, but we will try. And we will play it again because we will sing together. We'll try to sing together.
Oh my God.
It's really hard for me.
But no, just give it a try, okay?
Oh my God.
Yeah, don't worry. We'll just hymn. We'll just hymn together, okay? And Jaya, you can listen to the song now. Okay, come on, ladies, let's sing this song.
Together. Could I hold you close
Okay, guys. Okay, next time you have to go to karaoke with me.
Oh. With you only.
Oh my God.
We can all sing together. That was a quite difficult song. Okay, that's okay. Well done, everybody. Now we are going to transition to our next activity. Okay, so I want just to share my screen with you again. If you want to have a look at your echidnas under M2.4, we have current affairs, and today we're going to look at the current affairs too. So if you want to open that up in your own computer, that's okay. Okay. So in the current affairs song 2, I'm just going to open that on my window. So you can see here, there is a video which we are going to watch. And then after that, we're going to read the transcript together. And then after that, we're going to talk about this video. So I'm going to share the video with you. Can you see my screen?
Yes. Yep.
And I'm just going to make it bigger. And I'm going to start the video now. So let's have a watch of the video. We're going to watch it 2 times. And so first time we're going to watch it. Second time we're going to read the transcript. And third time, first time we'll watch it, then we'll read the transcript, then we'll watch it again. Okay, let's get ready.
Handwritten note. It's probably been a while. So when was the last time that you wrote a handwritten note? It's probably been a while. Technology has changed the way we communicate. We send emails, not letters, text messages, not phone calls. We order delivery instead of cooking dinners in our kitchen, all in the name of efficiency. But here's the point. Technology has made it easier to communicate, but it hasn't made it easier to connect with other human beings. I found that the secret to connecting in the high-tech, fast-paced world that we live in is doing a few small things the old-fashioned way. Write a letter. I've written thousands of handwritten notes, thanking people for advice, thanking them for an interview. It just puts that extra effort to show someone that you really care and that you're willing to go above and beyond. Some advice for writing a thank you letter is to really make it clear to the person that you're writing to the impact that they have had on your life. Talk about something specific, like thank you for the advice that you gave me. It's because of the advice you gave me that I am now doing X. People are looking to make a difference. And so if you can show someone that they've really had an impact on the life that you're living, the life you're pursuing, it can have a huge impact. Pick up the phone and dial. We've hired thousands of employees, and I've personally called every single one of them to welcome them to the Compass family. I'm able to set the tone of really what I want the company to be, where you know people go above and beyond to make people feel welcomed and to give people a sense of belonging. And sometimes I call people on their last day of work. When people leave, sometimes they're more transparent than they ever were when they were actually still at the company. And so it's a great opportunity to get the kind of feedback that it's very hard to get otherwise. Ask interesting and meaningful questions when you get outside of the office. When I'm traveling the country, every single night, I'll have a dinner with people in the company. And I like to ask questions like, what's your underlying motivation? What's something that happened this week that meant a lot to you? And when you go around the table and people really open up and people are able to engage, it sets a different tone. When people come back to the office, they can see each other and they know each other in a deeper way. Answer questions with honesty. Now, you know how it feels when you go into an elevator and someone says, how was your weekend? It could have been like the best weekend ever. You could have met the love of your life, the person you want to marry, and you would say, good. How was yours? If you want to connect with people, then you have to open up. I'm not always that good at it, and I imagine most people aren't, but that's why being open stands out so much, because most people aren't. Turn the video on. I would always recommend a video conference over a phone call, because that's when you can see the real personality come out. When you're on video, you're forced to be present. It's almost a forcing mechanism to be in the moment. Nobody succeeds alone. The more you can take time to develop genuine, authentic relationships, the more you're gonna be able to realize your dreams, because you're gonna be able to take big risks and know that there's gonna be a network of people out there to cheer you on and to support your efforts.
Sometimes you need to get away from the kids for grown-up time. We'll get away from the grown-ups for kids.
Sorry, guys. What did I do? Okay, so I'm going to stop sharing that, and I'm going to share another screen with you guys. Just give me 1 second. Okay. And so we're going to learn the transcript. All right. So hi, good to see you, Le. Hi, Chao Su.
Yes, teacher. How are you?
Good. Good to see you. Okay. So the first part, Miss Andrea, it's your turn.
Transcript. So when was the last time? Sorry, John. When was the last time that you wrote a handwritten note? It's probably been a while. Technology has changed the way they communicate. We send emails, not letters, text messages, not phone calls. We order delivery instead of cooking dinners in our kitchen, all in the name of efficiency. But here's the point. Technology has made it easier to communicate, but it hasn't made it easier to connect with other human beings. I found that the secret to connecting in the high-tech, fast-paced world that we live in is doing a few small things the old-fashioned way.
Thank you. Write a letter. Chao Su, could you read this part for us, please? Chao Su, you there? Okay. John Ben, can you help me?
Okay. Write a letter. I write hundreds of
thousands
of handwritten notes, taking people for as why thinking then for an
interview.
It's just put that extra offer to show someone that you really care and that you waiting to go about and be young, some as why for writing a thank you, Lester. It to really make it clear to the person that you're writing into, to the impact that they have hand on your rights. Talk about something specific, right? Thank you to sorry for the SY that you give me is because of the SY you give me that I am now doing X.
Yeah.
People are looking for make a difference. And so if you can show someone that they really has an impact on the right that you living the rights you're fulfilling.
Yeah.
It could have a huge impact.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah.
Your turn. Pick up the phone and dial. Leda, you're on the mute.
Okay. Pick up the phone and dial. We have hired thousands of employees, and I have personally called every single one of them. Welcome them to the Compass family. I'm able to set the tone of really what I want the company to be. Where, you know, people go above and beyond to yep. make people feel welcomed
yep.
and to give people a sense of belonging.
Yep.
And sometimes I call people on their last day of work. When people leave, sometimes they are more transparent than they ever were when they were still at the company. And so it's a great opportunity to get feedback that is very hard to get otherwise.
Thank you. Haley, can you do the next one, please? Ask interesting and meaningful questions.
Ask interesting and meaningful questions when you get outside of the office. When I'm traveling the country, every night, I will have dinner with people in the company. And I like to ask questions like, what's your underlying motivation? What's something that happened this week that means a lot to you? And when you go around the table and people really open up and are able to engage, it sets a different tone. When people come back to the office, they can see each other and they know each other is in deeper way.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Can I ask Jaya to do the next one, please?
You know how it feels when you go into an elevator and someone says, how was your weekend? It could be the best weekend ever. You could meet the love of your life and you would say, good, how was yours? If you want to connect with people, then you have to open up. I'm not always that good at it. And imagine most people aren't. But that's why being open stands out so much, because most people aren't.
Thank you. And Regina, can we see this one for you, please?
Turn the video on. I would always recommend a video conference over a phone call, because that's when you can see the real personality come out. When you're on video, you are forced to be present. It's almost a forcing mechanism to be in the moment.
Thank you. And Chow Su, can you do the last one, please?
Yes, teacher. Nobody succeeds alone. The more you can take time to develop genuine, authentic relationships, the more you are going to be able to realize your dreams. You are going to be able to take big risks and know that there's a network of people to clear your own and to support your efforts.
Okay, beautiful. So this is the transcript of the film or the video we've watched. So we're going to watch again the video. After we watch the video, I'm going to put you into groups and I am going to ask you to read and understand the transcript better with your group mates. So for now, let's watch the video again.
Good time. And just get away together. Holidays not far away. Book the private home that makes the holiday with Stays.
Okay. Sorry, what happened? Okay, I need to wait for 5 seconds before it clears out. Okay. All right.
Take the first step towards mastering the art of public speaking by checking out TED Masterclass today.
So when was the last time that you wrote a handwritten note? It's probably been a while. Technology has changed the way we communicate. We send emails, not letters, text messages, not phone calls. We order delivery instead of cooking dinners in our kitchen, all in the name of efficiency. But here's the point. Technology has made it easier to communicate, but it hasn't made it easier to connect with other human beings. I found that the secret to connecting in the high-tech, fast-paced world that we live in is doing a few small things the old-fashioned way. Write a letter. I've written thousands of handwritten notes, thanking people for advice, thanking them for an interview. It just puts that extra effort to show someone that you really care and that you're willing to go above and beyond. Some advice for writing a thank you letter is to really make it clear to the person that you're writing to the impact that they have had on your life. Talk about something specific. Like, thank you for the advice that you gave me. It's because of the advice you gave me that I am now doing X. People are looking to make a difference. And so if you can show someone that they've really had an impact on the life that you're living, the life you're pursuing, it can have a huge impact. Pick up the phone and dial. We've hired thousands of employees, and I've personally called every single one of them to welcome them to the Compass family. I'm able to set the tone of really what I want the company to be, where, you know, people go above and beyond to make people feel welcomed and to give people a sense of belonging. And sometimes I call people on their last day of work. When people leave, sometimes they're more transparent than they ever were when they were actually still at the company. And so it's a great opportunity to get the kind of feedback that it's very hard to get otherwise. Ask interesting and meaningful questions when you get outside of the office. When I'm traveling the country, every single night, I'll have a dinner with people in the company. And I like to ask questions like, what's your underlying motivation? What's something that happened this week that meant a lot to you? And when you go around the table and people really open up and people are able to engage, it sets a different tone. When people come back to the office, they can see each other and they know each other in a deeper way. Answer questions with honesty. Now, you know how it feels when you go into an elevator and someone says, how was your weekend? It could have been like the best weekend ever. You could have met the love of your life, the person you want to marry, and you would say, good. How was yours? If you want to connect with people, then you have to open up. I'm not always that good at it, and I imagine most people aren't, but that's why being open stands out so much, because most people aren't. Turn the video on. I would always recommend a video conference over a phone call, because that's when you can see the real personality come out. When you're on video, you're forced to be present. It's almost a forcing mechanism to be in the moment. Nobody succeeds alone. The more you can take time to develop genuine, authentic relationships, the more you're gonna be able to realize your dreams, because you're gonna be able to take big risks and know that there's gonna be a network of people out there to cheer you on and to support your efforts.
Ah, why did I press that?
No text.
Just give me 1 second, guys. Okay. All right, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put you all in a breakout room. And I want you to read the transcript again with your group mates. And I want you to explain. If someone doesn't understand it, try to explain it to each other. Okay. Another thing is I would want you all to turn on your camera while you are in a breakout room so that you can see each other's faces. Is that all right? Yes. Thank you very much, Miss Andrea. Thank you, Leda. So for the rest of you, turn on your camera. Thank you. Good to see you guys. See? Look at that. Okay, beautiful. So I'm going to put you into a breakout room now. There will only be 2 breakout rooms, so don't stress.
Sorry, Miss May. When I can find this reading?
Okay. So I'll show it to you, Leda. So you have to go. I'll show it to you. Just give me 1 second, please.
Okay.
Okay, so you can see it in your Moodle, in your Echidnas module 2.
Okay.
Okay, and just go a little bit down to where current affairs is.
Okay, current.
And it's current affairs number 2. Okay. All right. Leda, your dog is upset or hungry?
No, because my dog, when show the people to come in the window and he...
Oh, if he sees people, get make noise. Yeah. Good dog. Okay, everybody go now to your groups. And then after this activity, I'm going to have some questions and then we will answer. And then after that, we're going to have a game. Okay, so get ready. It's going to be fun. Okay, now go to your rooms. Yes, please go to your groups. Beautiful. Good job. Okay. Okay, we're just gonna wait for the others to join us. Welcome back. Okay, everybody, we're back. Okay, beautiful. So I think you'll now have a better understanding of the video and the passage. So I'm going to ask you some question. Okay, let me start with Haley. Haley, yes. What is the video about?
About how to get the best connect with other best ways, maybe pick up do a call or writing letter to make human is more connect.
Okay. Connected to each other, more personalized level. Jaya, how did you understand this video or reading? What is it about?
It's about how to create a stronger connection with other human beings.
Mm-hmm.
And they mentioned 5 ways to create a connection.
Okay. Yeah, thank you. And Regina, can you tell me what this video is about?
I think to tell you the good way to the good way to listen the video to build habit is maybe is useful to your life.
Okay. Leda, can you tell me what is the video about?
The video explain the way how you have to get for example to have yourself or which Allah to connect it and for the way you can say it, I understand, but sorry, this explain is that.
Okay.
I can see more.
John Pan, what is the video about?
Video is about teach you a technology how to change from the writer and pick up phone mean it's a tag the email or message to the friend or each other and for order anything that you need.
Okay. Yes. Chow Su, what is the video about?
I think that there is about the technology of communication and connecting.
Okay, and Miss Andrea, what is the video about?
The video shows the technology we change. We use the smartphone, we use computer, we use internet.
Yeah.
But did not change this how joined the people. And I think make some advance how can easily join easily. Think what how that think other people. Example, when we go to the restaurant and different communication than in the office, and make true question. It's not only how we're going, and don't interest with the answer. I think, but this is not a video. The communication is there, but we too far. Communication separate many times.
Okay, thank you. I'm going back to Haley. Haley, how important is having stronger connections with people to you? Is it important to have strong connections?
Yes, because if you want to be successful, you can't do that alone. You need some support from others. Then it's better to know something from others, how to do it better, or listen to other people's advice. To make yourself better.
Okay. Jaya, how important is having stronger connections to you? Is it important? Do you think you don't need it? Jaya, are you there? Okay, I'll get back to Jaya. Regina, how important is having strong connections to you?
Strong connection.
Yeah.
It's about the friend or something.
It doesn't matter. Yeah. Well, we have different kinds of connections with people. So we have friends, we have family, we have business networks, you know. So how important is having stronger connections to you?
Because if we don't have strong connection, we may make the world worse because we don't have some connection and communication like that. And it's good for the each people the health, because connection can influence the psychologic something like that. Yeah.
Okay. So it can influence your behavior.
Yeah.
Jaya, are you there, Jaya? Okay. Leda, how important is having stronger connections to you?
Sorry, teacher. My question is what I thinking or about the reading?
No, for you.
Okay, what I might think. Okay. Yeah. Okay. How important is having stronger? Okay, for me, is very important because that helped me to have a contact with the person, with the people. Helped me. Maybe I have a question. Maybe I don't know something. I have to ask. Other person is near my mind. If I have a problem, I have to ask other people, and maybe that have to give me the good result, the good way. And I'm a person, very solar, shiny person, and I need, because this is a good way to have a contact with the person for psychopath. Where is the name in English? Oh my God. To have a good feeling.
Okay. Janpan, how important is having stronger connections to you?
It's really important to me. To give me, I can to learn anything. I don't know before, or I can see the own friend or someone I lost from the many years ago.
Yeah.
And anything and I don't know, I can use if in if not strong connection, it's come very slow. I do something or I do some work.
Okay. Okay. Chow Su, how important is having stronger connections to you? Chow Su, you there?
Yes, teacher.
How is it important to have strong connections? Is it important or not?
I don't know how to answer, teacher.
So, you know, having a strong connections to people, do you think it is important or not important?
Important, teacher.
Why?
Why
is it important to have connections with people?
We need to feel supported.
Yep.
And loved.
Okay.
Those who have good relationships mm-hmm. are happier, healthier, and live longer than those who report feeling lonely.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Miss Andrea, how important is having stronger connections to you?
A stronger connection is moderately important for me because I think I am an introvert person. Mm-hmm. I like to live alone, only small group. Mm-hmm. I think this is different people, different behavior.
Mm.
And I send strong connection only a family member and like small friend. I think a little bit different.
Okay, but having a stronger connections doesn't mean you have to have a lot of friends. It just means that the people you're around with, you know, your feelings with them are stronger. It
doesn't understand your question. My daughter psychologist and we speak each other in this program
mm-hmm.
and I know I a little bit so not extrovert.
So your connection with people, you can say it's in moderation.
Moderation.
Okay, beautiful. Next, let's go on and I will go back to Haley again. Haley, how are the tips from the video help you build strong connections? Which one do you think you will do? Are you going to do all those five tips or just one or two of them? And which ones?
It's difficult to write in letter now. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because it takes too long time to deliver, to send a letter to others. And maybe...
But don't you think that this it's more special? If you maybe you don't have to write a letter that contains immediate information with action, but I think maybe sending a postcard would be a nice thing.
Yeah, that's nice. Postcard is nice, or maybe because the phone call I still always ring to others. I hate text because I don't know they understand my mind or not. Mm. If I call them, okay. They will understand what I'm meaning.
Oh, so it's clearer.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, sometimes the emotion or something. Yeah, I don't want to make some bad feeling. I have feeling for others. So mm-hmm. I always do the phone call, give the phone call to others. Yes.
Okay, good. And Jaya, what about you? Is Jaya here?
Yes, teacher, can you hear me?
Yes, okay. So, how are the tips from the video going to help you build strong connections?
Write a letter mm-hmm. to others.
Yeah.
And pick up the phone calls and dial because they said nowadays we only text messages. We send only messages.
Mm-hmm.
Don't call or pick up the calls like that. And next one is ask questions.
Mm-hmm.
Answer the questions with honesty.
Mm.
when you talk with others, mm-hmm. It's better to turn the video on,
mm.
like that.
So those are some of the ways on how the video can help you.
Yes.
Okay. Regina, what about you? How are the tips from the video going to help you build strong connections? Which ones will you use?
I think videos, because is it video is look like FaceTime?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think video is can look each face and can like pretend you can imagine you can see how sad they are and how happy they are, and it's like the it's like the normal talk.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think it's very good to good technology and it's used for them phone call, because phone call I think it's basic, basic call. When you want to when you want to get out your some emotional, so I think this is good way.
Thank you, Leda. How are the tips from the video going to help you build strong connections?
I agree with the answer question with the honesty, and why not turn the video on?
Okay.
This is, I prefer the 5-way, but this is more
suitable, you think?
Yeah.
What about Pan? How are the tips from the video help you build strong connections?
I think for trees, writing a register, pick up the phone call and the video, turn on the video.
Mm-hmm.
I can tell a story because in my country, go back to 30 years ago, not have the technology. If someone have the palm pen, you have to writing a letter, set in a post office for many days.
Yes.
You know, after you die already. Yes. Then because it's someone in a family get sick or extend, say in a hospital.
Right.
Yes.
Right.
Very pom-pom. But after 30 years, you have the phone, but not smartphone. You just only for call. But you not see the face. You not see on the you feel good or you on you smile or not smile. But now you can be the video call.
Yeah. Good. Thank you, Chow Su. How are the tips from the video help you to build strong connections? Which one will you use?
Yeah, on video, teacher.
Yeah.
Because we can share on video, smiling, laughing, the happy things and sad things. We can talk face to face.
You think video is the good one?
Yeah, good one. Yes.
Okay. Miss Andrea, how about you? How are the tips from the video going to help you build strong connections?
It's an interesting and meaningful question. This is true. But next paragraph, answer question with honesty. I don't like lie. I spoke true, but I don't know, give more information about me.
Okay. And
the last sentence, interesting. But this way being open stand out so much, because most people aren't. I think if I give more information, this can reverse for me. I think this is will be dangerous and other situation. But only I think I am afraid. So this good asking, but I better like listen and don't speak.
Okay. So there are some kind of situation when you are not comfortable
about
those.
I think that this I a lot of bad experience about people. So I'm a little bit afraid give too much information about me.
Okay. Thank you for sharing. Okay, the last question. What other things do you do to maintain good connections with your family members that are living far away from you? Haley, what do you do?
I always phone them at least one time per week. And I will, I just make the phone call to them. Then others, I think phone call is enough.
Okay. Do you remember important occasions like their birthdays or anniversary? And do you call them? Okay.
I call them.
Remembering them on their important days.
Yeah, not just in the schedule.
Okay, beautiful. Jaya, what do you do to maintain good connections with family and friends that are living far away from you?
Normally, I talk with them at least twice in a month. Especially any special occasions for their birthdays or I call them. And that's it, teacher.
Okay. Regina, how do you maintain good connections with your family and friends that are living away from you?
We usually video because my family will see me what am I look now. How thin and I
how thin you are. You should eat.
I think some concern is like the care action is also give me give me a warm warm emotional
support. Good. What about Leda? Leda, how do you maintain good connections with your family and friends that are living far away?
I call a phone because I have my parents in Italy and I call one a week and some friends, but one a month. And when have the, I write every date, her birthday or maybe something, and I call maybe first in that time.
Oh, that's nice. That's really thoughtful.
I do that, but
Good. Okay, what about Pen? How do you maintain good connections with your family and friends that are living far away?
I call my mom every day and my sister every day too, because I don't want to lose my mom. My father, he passed away when he young. I have only mom, I don't want to lose again. I want to make she happy and stay good on the time. I want to save her for saving me long time.
Yes. Thank you for sharing. Chow Su, how do you maintain good connections with your family and friends that are living far away?
My family and friends are live far away. I usually make video call.
Okay.
Get involved in a local community group or club.
Yeah.
This give my children the chance to get to know new people.
Yeah.
And see community members working.
Okay.
Together.
Okay. Good. Okay. Miss Andrea, how do you maintain good connections with your family and friends that are living away from you?
I use Skype and Viber. This way I can see my friends, my family member. And I call with them often. And I greet them birthday. Mm-hmm. And if I can meet, I give small present, not big, but then I think they like.
Okay, good. For me, in my case, you know, my family love to eat.
I don't think so. If I see you, I don't think so.
My family love to eat. So what I do is sometimes, I don't know if you have this in your country, but in my country, we have this called Food Panda. Okay, it's an app.
So
I can order food from Filipino restaurants and I can have it delivered to my parents' house.
Oh my god.
Yeah, so sometimes because we like to go out, we like to eat in restaurants, but now we can't do it because of COVID, right? So most of my memory with my family is in a restaurant, eating, you know, going to the hotel, but we can't do that anymore. So every time I'm missing my family, I would send them food.
Oh my god.
Yeah. I would, even if there is no occasions. Of course, if it's my mom's birthday or my dad's birthday or Mother's Day or Father's Day, I would send food and flowers like that. But just sometimes when I really miss them, you know, I'll just remember a really good time we had in a restaurant, and I will order those food, and then I will send it to them, and then we'll have a video call and they're eating and I'm so happy, you know, watching them and having a good time. So that is a special thing that I normally do with my family when I miss them. And also here in Australia, we have like a big box, you know, and we can put all the different kinds of things. So when you go on a sale, you put all these things and then you send it back to the Philippines. It takes 2 months.
By ship.
So because if it's by plane, it's too expensive, right? So it's by ship. So what I normally do is starting September, I start buying food for everyone.
Put it in a box.
And it's so funny. And then during Christmas time, my dad will dress like Santa Claus.
Oh my god.
And give these little boxes and give little gifts to the children, my niece and nephews. And so even if I can't be with them, it's just these little things that I do for them. So yeah, those are little things that I do for my family and friends back home. Now, what we're going to do is we have a little bit more time, but we only have 10 minutes. What I want you to do is I want you to spend 1 or 2 minutes, look for something in your house, in your room or something that is special to you, important to you, and tell us the story of that particular small things, not a big thing. You can talk to about your dog if you want, but I'm going to give you 1 or 2 minutes to get that thing, and then you're going to share with us a story about that small thing so that we can get to know you a little bit better. Okay, so grab your stuff for 1 or 2 minutes.
I want to show something, but
is Andrea, yeah, has a question.
I have a question.
Yeah.
When we see the video, I didn't understand the speaking. This is normal speed. This is normal speed. I more understand the reading, but I think never nothing when I listen.
For the TED Talk, yes. The TED Talk that I shared with you is actually normal speed. You're right. So just get me.
This is catastrophe.
Yeah, it's
if I can read, I more understand, but this.
Yeah, it's a little bit fast actually. But if I can share with you the screen, just give me 1 second. It's just advertisement here a little bit, but I'll show it to you. Okay, so. Okay, so can you see this?
Yes.
Sorry. There's an advert. Okay. So if I click here, you can see the speed of the video, right? So normal. I put that in normal. So if you think that it's too much for you, you can put it in 75.75 and it will be a little bit slower.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, but actually what we've watched is in a normal speed.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I can share with you this. Actually, you can get the link from the Moodle. And when you once you click it, you can change the speed. And then...
Please, a little bit bigger. I don't see...
Yeah, sure. So go to this like a wheel, you know, the wheel here.
Yes,
can you see?
Try a second. Okay.
Yeah. It's the wheel. And then you can just choose the speed that you want for the video. So if normal is too fast for you, maybe put this to 0.75x and then it will be a little bit slowly.
Thank you.
Yeah, no worries. Okay, now everybody grab your small thing and we're going to have a little bit of show and tell. What will you show me? I'm quite excited. We have 10 minutes to do this task. And then I'm going to give you a break so that you have a little bit of rest before your essay writing. Okay, Haley and Penn is looking for their things. Regina, can you turn on your video, Jaya?
Yo, I don't know why I cannot turn on. I'm trying to sit on my laptop, so but I don't know why it's not working.
Oh dear. Okay. What about Jaya? Jaya, your computer, your video? Okay, I'll just wait for Haley's. Oh, Haley's video is okay. Leda, your video. And we're just waiting for Ben. Okay, ready? Oh, okay. Who wants to volunteer? Ah, that's so cute. Who wants to volunteer? Haley, do you want to start? You're on the mute. Can you unmute yourself?
Yes, this bear is very big. I buy it in some clothes supermarket. It's only $10.
Okay.
After Christmas, then no one want to buy it. I saw this bear is alone in the shelf. So I bought it. Then it's important for me because when I live in Australia, he stay with me. And when I go to travel, even go to Sydney, Tasmania, or Perth, everywhere, I bring him, stay with me. Yes, I take picture. Then also, you know, Uluru?
Yes.
I climb the mountain, I climb on, then bring that.
Oh, he's traveling to Australia, yes, the traveling bear.
Yes, it's Uluru bear.
Oh my God.
So this is the most important thing, for me now.
Okay, so you're a baby bear. Beautiful. Yeah. Okay, Ben, what about you? What will you share to us?
Oh, I'm 1 minute, Miss May. I just share in.
Okay.
I just have to pick in a picture.
Okay.
I take a picture, yes.
Okay, we'll get back to you. Chow Su, what will you share with us?
I am in Sydney, teacher.
Okay.
I haven't went out and I have nothing to share.
But how long have you been in Sydney?
I think 1 week.
Are you going to stay there permanently?
No, I'm visit to my friend mother house.
Okay. Just on holiday?
Yes, like holiday.
Okay, but is it cold there today?
Very cold. Every day cold.
Oh dear. Here also is cold. Okay, so enjoy your time in Sydney, okay?
Thank you.
Okay, Leda, what do you want to share with us?
Okay, I want to share for my dog, Bianca. Okay?
Yeah.
You know Bianca. I think everybody in the class know Bianca because she's a girl.
Okay.
And Bianca is the best thing I was in Melbourne, in Australia. Mm. Because when I come, my brother gave me Bianca what he was, a little puppy. Mm. It was maybe 5 days. It was the same. I was in Melbourne, in Australia for 1 month, and I was Bianca. Mm. I should have a dog in my home because, you know, I have two children, but my daughter, it was very difficult. When she start to stay in Australia because she missed too much her things in Italia.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And she was very boring, anxious, and that. And I thought, okay, maybe it's good to give a dog because she said, I like the dog, but I never had a dog in Italy in my life. Never. Yeah. It's first time. And my brother gave me Bianca. Mm. I choose this name because Bianca is a name, Italian's name. Mm. And the meaning is white because this puppy, it was the white, the color very white.
Okay.
And I'm happy to, I'm and all my family and my George, my daughter, it was very happy. And I'm happy to have Bianca at home.
Okay, good. Miss Andrea, what about you? What will you share?
Similar topic. I love it because I would like to talk about my dog.
Mm-hmm.
My dog, this is my four-legged friend. She is a border collie, 8 years old.
Okay.
I got her when I was 7 years old.
Okay.
She is a rescued dog.
Rescued dog.
Very, very kind, very friendly. And when was locked down, I work always.
Yeah.
Because I can go outside because I work with dog.
Mm.
So, similar than Angelida, this is very good feeling when I walk, when I play with my dog.
Okay.
Very light.
Yeah, good. Okay, Jen Pen, ready?
Yep.
Okay.
Oh, I want to talk about my face.
Okay.
Then my face is, when I bought before and 3 years ago, it's very small. I cannot share, but I can share it.
Yeah, maybe you can share. Yeah, you can share it with us. Now you put yourself on mute, so we can't hear you.
Oh, okay.
You hear me now?
Yes.
I want to talk about my face.
Okay. You can just put it on the camera.
You see? Are you seeing? No?
Is that your fish? Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Fish?
Yes. Yeah. Did I form a tear? You look the back color after and now.
Nice.
Oh, yes, a little bit. Yeah, down there we can see, but it's too bright. Yeah. So it's no big fish.
No, it's very big.
Very big. I don't
see. No, it's too bright. We can't see.
Oh,
so
yeah, I don't see you.
But anyway, okay. So what's the name of your fish?
Oh, oh my God. Name. You ask me the name. I forgot the name.
Nickname?
My feet don't have name.
Okay, it doesn't have a name. Okay.
I think it's my stepson give the name before.
Mm-hmm.
For time when I came to Australia, my husband, he bought for me because I stay home for 3 months, not go out. He think, oh, keep you something busy because he busy with work, not have time to take me out.
Mm.
But when we go back to Thailand or our country, more than 2 weeks, they carry little feet. Save it, mother in law.
Yeah.
Or sometime in the father in law for 1 month. He said, oh, not again. I don't want to carry your tank.
Okay.
But now it's come very big. The back handle, they change for gold now.
Mm-hmm.
It's very big. But when you have seen now, everybody see now, they want my face.
They want your fish.
Yeah, but before, no, but now want. They ask me anytime when you go out again for 2 or 3 weeks. Give me.
Oh, they want to. Oh, okay. Now they want to take care of your fish before.
Yes.
Don't want.
Yes, because it's really big. I think 1 kilo. One.
Yes. Oh, that's a big fish.
When I clean the tank, I check the kilo. It's 1 for 1 kilo, 1 for 7 gram.
Oh my.
Yeah, it's really big. I sent tea tank already now.
Okay. Yes. Thank you for sharing. Regina, do you have anything to share to us?
Camping?
Yeah.
Did you remember last time we went to the camping?
Yes, yes.
And we have a course in that time.
Yeah,
it's like the Chinese painting and the
Chinese painting. Yes.
Yeah, and the owner gave me a book. Mm-hmm. It's give me a book. Inside is all of his painting.
Mr. Lee.
Yeah, Mr. Lee.
Oh, Mr. Lee is a famous painter in China.
Yeah.
Mm.
So I put in my book story.
Okay, that's great. Good on you.
Thank you.
All right. I'm going to share with you my little thing here, which is my teapot.
Teapot.
You see my teapot? Oh, so nice. Yes, it's a really cute teapot. So it has a teapot as well as a cup, so it goes together like this.
Oh, I have one set.
I see too.
Yeah. So one of my I came here as an international student, and one of my very good friend I met from the university gave this to me as a gift. And my friend is from Sweden, but unfortunately after she finished our course she has to go back to Sweden, so I couldn't really, you know, I couldn't see her anymore. And then we're planning to meet again for holiday, but then COVID, you know, COVID comes in, and I really miss her. And she's one of the really good friends that I had when I was in uni. We always, you know, work together and spend time together and go on different kinds of research forums together. So since I'm missing my friend and I couldn't see her in person, so I started using this teapot that she has given me. So it just reminds me of her, and I'm really looking forward to finish this pandemic so that we can all travel and meet each other again. And it's really good to have friends, you know, from different country. When I was we are like United Nations. There are people,
yes,
from, you know, people from South America, from different parts of the world, and there's really good.
Yeah.
So that's the story. That's the story of my teapot. All right. So are you guys happy with the class today?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. Did you learn something new about being connected to people? And hopefully, even if we are working together online, maybe one of these days we can all meet up and have coffee and some nice snacks together, so that we can really, you know, have a group chat rather than just seeing each other like this. Okay.
Yes.
So I'm going to let you go so that you can have a little bit of 10 minutes to freshen up for your next class. Thank you so much, everybody. Enjoy your weekend. Don't forget your homework. And I'll see you on Monday. Bye.
Sorry, teacher. Sorry.
Go on.
Okay. What is the homework?
Okay. So
can you show me, please? Because
yeah,
I don't know. I didn't know that.
Okay. So I'll share my screen.
And maybe you share your screen and then, okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So can you, is this grammar section here?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is in module 2?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you can do the grammar quiz during your free time. Yeah.
Grammar quiz, okay. Yeah.
And then if you go a little bit up here, there is M2 1.4 speaking?
I did that.
Yeah, this is speaking test will be graded. So you can practice as many as you can. And the deadline is on Sunday evening.
Miss May, I have a question.
Yes.
I say in spelling test assessment in with you in yesterday.
Okay.
But in a question 5, talk about the county seasons. I think 1 minute, it cannot finish talk. I think we need more 2 minutes or 3 minutes.
Okay, so it means to say you are talking more and more.
Yeah, because in some country have 4 season or 3 season, you know, we have to expand more, but 1 minute.
Yeah.
Not enough. I would miss more, 2 or 3 minutes.
So I will tell Miss Turner about that. But at this stage, we cannot change the timing because already people are already using it. So we can. So it's just 1 minute here. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I think it's number 5. Country seasons. I think.
Yes.
From yesterday.
Yeah. So maybe just make your speech a little bit shorter, so rather than 2 minutes.
Because we have same in Thailand, we have 3 season. We talk about all the tea. Some country have 4, you know.
Yeah. Yeah. So I'll take note of that and I'll ask Miss Turner to make it longer, but this time we cannot change it anymore. Because once people started answering it, you cannot change the
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, everybody. Thank you. You take care.
Okay,
bye.
Have a good night, teacher.
Yes, you too.